Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, we are talking about airplane etiquette. It's spring vacation time, so many are thinking about their upcoming trips. And if you are boarding a plane anytime soon, you may be thinking about the bad behavior of others, like kicking the back of the chair. Isn't that nice?
Awful.
Eating smelly foods.
Horrible.
Or even letting the kids scream their head off. So we wanted to know, what are the etiquette musts in your book? Do you have any? Because you were flying back and forth. You were here, you were in California, you were going back and
forth.
Yeah,
I was flying a lot, and that's a long flight, obviously.
That's a long
flight. Cross-country, it's like 5.5 hours, and it's airplanes are really where we see the erosion of common decency.
It's
because
true.
It's just the talking, where are you headed?
Mm-hmm.
As far away from you as possible,
right.
To another seat. If
yeah.
It's Southwest, I'm moving somewhere else. But you can't choose always who your neighbors are going to be on those long flights. And a lot of this, the armrest thing going on right
sure.
there, that's a bad one. Someone constantly getting up. And the food, you know, the breath, I mean, it's there's nowhere for you to go.
No, I know. Now, you would see videos before. When, you know, flight was like this elegant thing.
People would dress up.
People would dress up. The women would wear dresses and guys would wear suits.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I saw a video this morning of some lady being delayed in a flight at the American Airlines counter.
Yeah.
Screaming like a maniac.
Wearing pajamas, probably.
Yes.
You know, minion feet. People treat it like it's a slumber party.
Right. No, I know.
On the planet, I get it. You want to be comfortable, but it really is incredible. Like you just said, how it's morphed from, you know, the epitome of class to
now
just
anybody can get on a plane.
A locker room.
Right. Right. Or and that's a thing. Or you get the parent. You know, if you have kids, anybody who has kids understands. All right, kids get on a plane. They're tired. They don't feel like traveling.
Right.
They're all over the place. You get that they may have a little bit of meltdown. But there are parents who will just let the meltdown go.
Oh, absolutely.
And they don't even try to console them.
I know. They just let it go. And we're all trapped in this tube together trying to just get to a destination. We all just want to get somewhere.
I just want to get someplace warm.
I just want to
go someplace warm.
Get to Boise or wherever I'm going. But this is a terrible one. If you are bringing something that needs to go in the overhead,
right.
You should be, you do this sometimes, you get right in there.
Get right in, right
camera
four, right there.
You should be using the overhead above your seat.
Yes.
What about these people? They put theirs in the front of the plane and they're sitting in the back.
Right.
You can't do that.
No, or pack accordingly. You know how small the space is above the compartment.
Right.
Some people are like bringing body bags in the thing and like, you know, tossing it up.
No, and it's just you really want to have respect and for other people, and sadly, it's just one of those things. And what about these people who, when the plane reaches its destination and the plane is still sitting there, and we can't, they, well, it gets to the gate, they stand up right away.
Where are you going? Where are you going? Leave the tuna fish sandwiches at home. We don't need them.
I'm just gonna get to the bathroom here.
Do you need to use the restroom?
No, but that's the thing. No. Oh, you know what? Maybe I will use the restroom.
You got a window seat.
I gotta
tonight.
Get my
window
to the
seat.
Bathroom.
Ahead,
well, here's what our social media friends, pardon me, thank you, are saying about this topic today. Brian Yukono has the first word with something relevant to all of us. He says, if you require, here we go, frequent trips to the restroom, kindly don't take a window seat. John Kimball adds with authority, stop kicking my seat. Yeah, that's not good. And on Instagram, user at the Red Velvet Chew shares, do not give yourself a manicure / polish your nails. Yeah, don't be doing that on the plane, right? We don't want to see that. Be nice to your neighbor. Well, trending on this Tuesday from the New England Tech Center, we all know the power of music. It certainly plays a crucial role in my life. I have made no secret of my love for all types of rhythms and beats. From Springsteen to Huey Lewis, I know that the heart of rock and roll is indeed still beating. No, mercifully, I'm not about to break out into song again. Today, we will turn it over to the experts. We are talking dueling cellos, as the musical wizards behind Two Cellos show off their prowess in this dazzling battle, which depicts a spectacular crossover between the historic Beethoven's Fifth and the Led Zeppelin classic Whole Lotta Love. Check it out and get inspired. Absolutely fantastic. And how about this? We all know and love the Kiss Cam, right? At sporting events. But what about the Lion King cam? Yep, at the Denver Nuggets game the other night, proving in-arena entertainment inspiration can come from anywhere. Yeah, the camera scanned the crowd for babies, urging families to reenact the famous scene from the classic Disney film. And right now, drawing our inspiration from this, how could we not have some fun? Right there. I think Will and I are Lion King cam ready. And as always, calm down, everybody. Relax. He started this weeks ago by referencing that. From all of you, we want to hear from you guys. Oh, look who's coming over. Oh, I don't know. I don't think you can lift me.
No, we can't do it.
Follow us. Let us know what you thought about that horridness on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. All of those are at The Rhode Show.